Okay, see, for the past 2 hours, we have discussed about ship motions in irregular waves. So, I thought today we are going to go through a kind of a problem of how we proceed very slowly so that, you know, it gets to us. So, I have not, the numbers are not there, so we will work it out so we know, you know, how it goes. So, let us take an example. Let us say that I have a ship, say, let me also put its, you know, say its length is given, say 100 meter. Various particles are given, and its heave response, heave RAO, let me also say V equal to, let us say 20 knots, and wave heading, let us say beta or whatever you call. For this, heave response is given, let us say, which, let me, because I am inventing the problem, we plot with respect to lambda. So, let us say, I guess put some numbers here. Let us say it is given like that. Etc. So I'll just put some numbers here. I want to put this as 1. Say something like that. See, I just, well, you know, thought to take a realistic value. This is what typically happens. This is how you are going to be given in actual cases. For a given speed, in this case 20 knots, heading angle of 180 degree, heave RAO is given. The question that is asked is, determine the heave response that is significant heave, etcetera, in say C state 3, 4 and 5. Let us say that is the question. We will just take up some C state and we will try to do. So, question is that what is say some C state, or rather for that I will take some C state, okay, say 4, because after all the calculation is going to be repetitive. Okay. Not only that, when I say heave response, everything of heave, we have to get the spectrum, we have to get the area, then probably we have to write down things like what is significant heave height, heave absolute amplitude, what is significant heave velocity, what is significant heave acceleration, what is the chance of heave, if there are other questions asked, that also. Essentially, say significant values. Okay. and say C state is 3 given is, you know, like we will pick up some C state, H is 1/3 and T is given. We will say that for say the example is H is 1/3 or H is rather, H is say 3 meter or something like that, and T 1 or whatever is say 10 second, some value is given. Okay. This is the question, right. So, how do we proceed? See, the number one, first of all, we have to transform this to a basis of omega e versus RAO. No. Let us get the RAO first in the omega e basis. See, this is what I am saying, that the procedure says like this. Now, if I look at the procedure, I have S omega which will be defined like that. This is, I have say for H s equal to some given value and T 1 some given value. So, I will be knowing this as function of omega. This is what will be known from this formula, which will be in a computer program or something input, you know, and a spectrum type of formula. See, it will say ITTC spectrum, etcetera. Now, our calculation starts from here. From here, I have to get then my this RAO, I have to get, see this RAO will look like here in this case, this frequency is this thing, but I must transform that back to omega e, okay, and then of course I get the response taking exactly same points. So, I have to have a common basis first. No. So, let us take an omega e as a basis, we will keep this in mind and get back to that. So, we will have to keep that omega e in basis. Now, you see here I have been given lambda by L, L is actually 100 meter. How do I do it? First of all, remember that omega square, see I have to transform lambda by L to omega e, that is the first thing I have to do. I know this formula, that is omega equal to g into 2 pi by lambda. So, what I have, see here lambda by L, I have got, let us say, let us take say 1. So, that will give me lambda equal to 100 because L is 100 meter. So, that will give me omega, no, omega here, there is a square root there, right. I am sorry, this is. So, it will give me omega, right. See, I have to first transform this basis, this lambda by L to omega e, or rather I will get back to that. So, I have got here lambda by L values. So, I need to find out omega e. So, first thing is that I am just going step by step slowly, so that now I can regard L here. See here, if I take this 1.00, L is 100, this particular line. What is my omega? Omega is, so let me work it out this one. I just bought that, that is why. About 0.78, right. Okay. Now, what is omega e? Remember, I need, what is omega e formula? But this cos beta whatever. Now, here 180 degrees. So, this is coming to be omega into 1 plus. Okay. So, this will be, we can work it out this now, this omega 1 plus omega, V is how much? V is 20 north, 20 into 0.5144 by 9.8 omega 1 plus 20 into 0.5144 divided by 9.8, 1.049, right. This coming to 1.049, is it correct? Something like that it is coming. So, here, so this is going to become then this plus 1 no, sorry, 1.05 into, I am just going very slowly because we should do understand this. Point 64 something, okay. It may be whatever. So I am getting this. So you see now I am getting these new numbers, and of course I have the RAO. Okay. This you can check the numbers. So I am now got this table where I will write separate RAO table. Now the RAO that I have got here, I have got this plots, these values. All right. So I have essentially transformed that to this. Some values, it may not be equidistant, some value. So this part is coming here. So I have got now RAO value like that. So I have got omega e. Remember, these values are somewhere here. Why I am doing it? Because we will later on find out that it is important for us to know. We have got only something like, I have given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 points. So we have got 9 points somewhere. See, remember, I have no control on this distance, they must be equidistant. I have no control on this spacing, this arbitrary has come, this whatever omega is up there, arbitrary it has come. Okay, next question, I have to go to the spectrum. Now here I must understand one thing, you know, see here, this point and this point, I need to have the spectrum only within that region, maybe more, but let us, whichever way I want to see, I can see that, because I have only this much given, data given. Actually what happens in this kind of problems, you will find out that in case I need data beyond 4, I can make it 1, because it is becoming asymptotically 1, this. If I want it below this, I simply take it 0, because it is already too small. In fact, this is already, in fact, my diagram, it was something here. Okay. In case I have a spectrum which is spread, you do that, because my spectrum may come out to be something here, which we'll discuss that in a minute. Suppose my spectrum comes out to be something beyond that data given, then I should extrapolate this RAO. Now for spectrum, what I should do? First of all, you see that we realize one thing, that I have got this omega is. Now omega is got stretched on this side. Okay. So what I could do, just generally speaking, I could take first of all omega versus s omega, some omega. So I have to take certain omega, that I have to choose those. So now we coming to the spectrum part. So what I am going to do is that, next. So now this, I have again no choice for that particular spectrum for HS given and T1 given by a formula. So what I will do, I will use some omega and S omega. So there will be some values coming. Okay. So let us say I will take this to be say 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like that I go. Okay. Now omega, this of course I will find out whatever the value, I, you know, let us say this will turn out to be 0.5, say 1, say 2.5, say 3.9, like that, some number comes in meter square second, let us say. Of course here I will immediately go for omega e, this to this. What is omega e? Once again that we found out, no, omega into 1 plus, in this case, that is what it turned out to be. So 0.2 will become, let us just take an example, 0.2 will become 1.05 into 0.2, 0.242 or so. Okay, this formula and S omega E, this will become, as you know, something like that. So this will become, for example, this number 3.9 will come down, maybe it will become maybe 3.1, because you know it will come down slightly and get stretched. Okay, so my point is, remember that this point that I got, again some arbitrary number, I do not have much choice. Okay, so here comes, that means what I end up getting is, now if I were to plot here omega E versus S omega. Now I have got actually some points, this, some point of which I do not have basically a control. I can have a control, you may say, on omega, because I could choose 50 points, 50, etcetera, but the point is that making too many points will make no sense, because ultimately I have only data points given for the array of fixed 7 number of points. So I have got two bases. So here I want to tell you this. So I have got two data thing. One is omega E versus RAO, and another one, this is one, another one was omega E versus S omega E. This and these are not necessarily coincidental. Okay. So therefore, when I want to make a table, then I will have to make an interpolation. So what we will do is that we will take the first one to be the correct one. That means now I will write down here the final one, omega E and RAO. So I have got this, whatever that values I have got, omega E versus RAO, well, let us say some values. Now see, when I write this S omega E here, this I am going to get from interpolation, which means, see, I have got this, my, if I were to plot here, my RAO points were this one. So what I am doing is that I am trying to find out for this one what is this value, this one what is this value, this one what is this value. My blue line is the base, this is my RAO, this is my S omega E. So you see here what I have done, that my omega E versus RAO, this points are the blue points, see, that is this points. Okay. For the same one, I must produce this from interpolating from that omega E S omega E graph. This is very important, this interpolation part, interpolation, extrapolation, whatever you call. Okay. See here, this particular one, once again I had this black line. As an example, if I just want to give an example, omega E here, RAO, I am again just giving an example, say this was 0.56, this was 0.79, this was 0.85, etcetera, and I have separate diagram of omega E, say 0.5, 0.7, 0.9, 1.1 S omega E's. Some values are there. Now what I need at 0.56, I want to find out S omega E. So I need to interpolate from there and get this value. I had 0.5, 0.7, 0.9. This is 0.56, this one. I need at 0.56 my s omega e. So I need to interpolate that. Very, very important that we have to get the same value here. Okay, so we are getting it now. So once I get that value, now the basis is clear. So now I've got for the same one this lines by interpolation, right? Then my rest part is all very simple. Now the rest part of calculation is only calculation part. Now next line is going to be what it is going to be. See here, RAO is a SOA is there. Therefore, I can straightforward write actually that my S Z omega E, it is going to be RAO square into this. That is, if I call this A, if I call it B, this is going to be A into B square. Straightforward. So you can fill it up this column. Okay, but now an interesting point. Remember, I wanted to also find out velocity and acceleration. What is my velocity RAO? It is this RAO into omega. So if I want RAO of velocity, what is this RAO of velocity? RAO of motion into omega e. So all I do is get this value here, multiplying this column with this column, I get this value. Okay, this value is this into this, so this column I get. So once I get this column, once again I get the S Z dot omega e, that is velocity . See response spectrum is going to be A square B, yeah, because we have done it absolutely, sorry, this is square of this into this, because I B into A square. So I get this one. All right, now what is happening, in order for me to do velocity and acceleration, all I have to do is to get the, just replace this. Replace this is what? Velocity RAO is going to be this into this column. So it's like, you know, Excel file means you simply multiply this with the, you know, this two square. So you will end up getting this column. Okay. If I want acceleration, what I should do? Well, in fact, you can also see that because it's a square here. In fact, I could have got this by simply squaring this. You know, that RAO power of 4 into this would have been given me this straightforward. It's the same thing, but doesn't matter. We can go this way. So what I will do? Next one, I have to simply replace this by omega e square into RAO for acceleration. So I will end up getting, if I, because this the thing ran out, so I will end up getting omega e s, let me write the other way down here, s omega e RAO z s z. Then I write RAO velocity, then S velocity omega e, then RAO acceleration, then S acceleration omega e. So you see this. So this is my all these values. This is my transforms web spectrum, right? This is my Heave RAO and Heave spectrum displacement. So having done that, of course, very simply you can plot the graphs then we are going to, we will be doing that, and then we simply plot this graph. This is going to be SZ, which may turn out to be something like that, then SZ dot may come out to be something like that. Okay. You will end up getting, because you have got these points. So, this we have done, but you know typically, so I have put the spectrum plot, but this is not where we normally would end. We would like to know, as I said, HS1 the significant heap. So, of course, at the then what happened? You must actually integrate this area numerically or whatever. Now, typically what happened in this kind of cases, it is easier to use trapezoidal integration, straightforward, if you have a too small part here, because it, you need not do our traditional 1-for-1 type of rule. So, I can simply in fact integrate whichever way you like. Trapezoidal means just take some of the entire thing with only the first 2 half and then multiply with whatever, but here there is a problem. Actually, you need to do, you cannot use 1-for-1 rule in any case. Why? Because this number, remember, are not unidistributed, you have no control. So, this and this not uniformly spaced. So, the spacing of omega e is not uniform at all. So, what you have got here in this diagram is that this point, this point, this point, this point, this point, this point, etcetera, these gaps are not uniform. So, better is to simply use trapezoidal, you know, like trapezoidal distribution, this area, etcetera, this area, etcetera. Okay. So, better way of for this spectrum is to use an integration, and it is good enough to use trapezoidal integration. If you use trapezoidal integration, you get them. So, you will end up getting these areas m 0s, m 0 for z, m 0 for v, m 0 for acceleration. Then the rest part is very simple. Then you find out what is my heap 1/3 for 2 square root of this, what is my velocity 2 square root of this, etcetera. You will end up getting that. Check the so called your units, you will also find the units properly. So, this is what is a procedure that applies to any response, you know. And if you work it out, you will be able to find out whichever you like. Now, my point of saying this is again that remember one thing, that initially I started this saying is that the data is given in terms of lambda by L. Okay. It may not be lambda by L, it can have been given in terms of omega e, it can be given in terms of something else, does not matter whichever way it is given. Please understand the response would be given always against in some sense frequency or period. You have to transform that to corresponding omega e. That is the first step, that is very very important. You have to transform that to the corresponding omega e. The spectrum, of course, you are doing against omega, not omega e, but then for the given v and beta, you have to transform to omega e. So, this way we can do etcetera. Now, so this is should be very clear, we could end up doing this problem several times, and it is not really a problem. This particular process should be automated in a computer program or something. So, you read RAO over a base, whichever way it is, you read as an input data H1/3 significant or C state, immediately you construct, you have to have your inbuilt points. So, only thing that one has to remember that when you are doing these points, this coming back again to this, see I have given this REOs. So, REOs are given from here to here. So, the spectrum that you use should cover at least that much. Because if it did not cover, supposing I use spectrum only up to some point, well, you are missing out something. So, in other words, this point I will elaborate here, that suppose my RAO is given only this much, the spectrum that I used should cover, actually technically should cover 0 to 0 almost. So, it should cover wherever it coming 0 all the way to where it coming 0, at least this much it should cover. Although this is given this to this, then of course, you may say, well, I do not know this site. Well, there are many ways, sometime you can just extrapolate this site if you want the RAO base. Typically, as I said, RAO is always given starting from very small going to an asymptotic limit. RAO typically for heave and all that has a very small value, well small value peaks and it approaches an asymptotic value. So it will be given from somewhere here to here. This side, if you not, you take it 0, this side you take that last value, typically for extending it. Are you getting what I am saying? See, once again I repeat in a bigger graph, I have the spectrum like that, but somebody gave me RAO which is just this much of point from here to here. This is my RAO, but my spectrum is, see here I have, that means what? I have lot of waves of this type, but no RAO is given. So if I were to use spectrum only up to using this much point, then I am not getting the full spectrum. See, I end up getting a response spectrum which may look like that, but I am missing out some part. So what I could do is I could use here an asymptotic extrapolation to the last value, and here I can take it simply going down to 0. Then I will, even once you do few times, you will know, you know, get an idea. Otherwise, the point is, consider all waves that exist in that ocean and their response, even if the response is, otherwise you would have been missing out. That means there are some waves existing whose response you did not consider in calculating this value. Okay. So this is how we kind of go. Now there is a reverse issue also involved, you know. The reverse is like this, which is sometimes done in experiment and all that. Supposing I have, which also we could do here. I think there is a problem there. I could do, just one second. What has happened is something like that. Sometime in experiment and also in measurement, you know this, you have measured, well, you have this S omega E and you have measured your spectrum is given, input spectrum, and your response spectrum is given. What it means is that you are doing an experiment, you have sent an irregular signal, irregular wave, you measure the response and you end up getting this graph. How you are doing, remember, you are it is very interesting. See, you are basically making only one run, because you have a tank, you are sending this signal. Okay, you are sending this signal. Remember, I have this tank here, or in a ship, or rather, let me put it the other way around also, that I have basically going on board a ship. I know the sea state there. I might have measured by some equipment, so I know this absolute sense or encountered sense, and I measured the heave response of the hull. It is more relevant in experiment that I send a spectrum, I would be sending this. That means I am sending input spectrum, okay, in a tank here I am sending this spectrum. So I have a probe here, it measures this. Understand that there is a probe here which is measuring this, obviously, because I am sending the signal, and there is a ship here which is moving forward at certain model V and at certain beta. Now I measure on that its response. That means I am measuring here eta t, and I am measuring here in absolute sense z t. That can be done by one series of tests, because once I send that, I am sending it once, and I am doing test number 1, run number 1, send this signal, get this. Find out, the question is, what is the RAO? Find out what is RAO. Now if I had to find RAO, then I have to find individually these RAOs. Remember, I have to send once a sine wave of frequency equal to some value, next time another one. So each one of them represents one experiment, whereas here I am getting this from one experiment, the entire graph. See, I am doing an experiment. Okay. Now, in the experiment, what I do? I send an irregular wave signal, which is possible to send from one side, an irregular signal, which means I am sending a signal which is like this, measured at some space fixed point, which is how you do it, because you have no control, I mean like you cannot, you are not measuring with respect to this, you do not put a stick on that. So, this is your input spectrum. What did you measure? You measure for this shape, for that particular speed and heading, you measured its ZT here. Obviously, this can be broken down by standard spectral method and the spectrum can be plotted. So, you have given this, measured this, one run, run number 1, HS 1/3 equal to 3 meter, equivalently you have produced this signal and broken it down, made it up. Find out what is RAO. What I can do? Obviously, here I very simple, I can take this, I can take the corresponding value of this in, you know, if I take this as well A, this as C, remember B becomes, that is RAO, this B square root of C by A. Now, you see here what happened, I get the entire plot, because I can now take various points and I can get the entire plot. So, here I am getting this entire graph. Now, see the reverse, if I were to do this experimentally, if I had to find this experimentally, then I had to do so many tests for each point, one test, because each point represent one regular wave test. I am sending a regular wave and I am finding out the response. So, here the each, say I need something like 20 points to represent the graph. So, I have to do 20 tests, which is replaced by one test now. Sometime it is done, that is what I am saying. Sometime you can get back RAO, you can of course get back RAO provided you know this, because this formula holds good. In experimental, sometime if you can control well, you can actually measure this, given this, and get back this rather than the other way around. And a better experiment, of course, would be that you do this also, and you also do this, and then compare the two, and therefore you know how good your tests are in a C-keeping test. Okay. So, this is how we could kind of, you know, like do this sort of calculations for, you know, like what I should say, this ship motions part. Now, another thing I want to tell you now, let us say you are doing a ship motion part one part. In following wave now, following wave, so I have, you know, say in now, take a following wave. Say now my beta is 0 degree, okay. Some V is very high, say V is again 20 knots. So, I had this lambda by L versus RAO. So, this lambda by L becomes omega, this, you know, basically it becomes lambda. From there I can find out now the point, interesting point here is that see this omega is increasing, but this omega e, see what would happen, say 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1.0, I am just giving arbitrary, this turns out to be 0.15, 0.39, 0.45, 0.42 comes down, 0.31, 0.19, 0 minus 0.10, like that it will come in a following wave. See here this base now is not increasing, see it is increasing here and coming down. So, that is what I was trying to tell, that this graph now each point got transformed to like this, like this. This point is 0.45, 0.6, this 0.6, this one, then it is coming back. Okay. not only that, here when I now here at this point when I do now where I do s omega e by the formula, this turns out to be in this point basically something like infinity. So you are running a computer program, it may happen, you are not getting it clearly, I have to again explain that properly. You see the point here is that I had this omega, then I had to make omega e following wave. Remember, following wave my omega e against omega looks like this. What would happen is that omega e keeps on going up, right, omega increasing, but omega e increases up to this much. So omega e, that is what I said, 0.2, say 0.6, then say 1.0, say 1.4. So it increases, say this is 0.1, this increases to say 0.4, that is this value. After that it is begin to decrease, 0.3, 0.25, like that. At this point it becomes 0 here, and here it becomes minus 0.1, minus 0.3. Okay. What is my s? You will find that at this point my s omega e at this point is infinity, because omega e is will become infinity here, another graph, the s omega e goes to infinity, then comes back to infinity round like that. This is infinity at this point. When you are doing this program, you are going to encounter problem for the spectrum. Okay. You are going to find problem for the spectrum, and remember I have this, then next level is I have RAO, of course I have given, then I have got SZ which is square of that in this. So this also is going to be infinity or something, isn't it, at this point. Because this is infinity, square of that will give you this infinity. How are you going to find the area? You will have a lot of trouble, because what will happen, you are going to find, I give an example, you will find something like that, ultimately omega e versus your sz, you will find like that, something like say 0.3, 0.4, 0.45, then 0.41, 0.39, it will come down like that. Now here you will find some value, actually maybe this is actually going to be much smaller, in fact it is going to be, let us say this, you might end up getting a value of 10 to 10, this is actually say 3, this is 1, then again this is going to be some value. So you see here this value. So when you are trying to find the area by trapezoid, you are going to have trouble, because if you do in a computer program with a trapezoid, then you are going to end up getting, even though it is very large number 10 to the 10, you will end up getting a very large m0 if you do not take care properly. But what is the physics? The physics, of course I told before, this graph is actually like this, infinity, but it is a singular point, this area under that is actually very small. So what we should do in order to get around this, see there is a way of doing this, getting around this, you see. For area finding, we are not going to use this at all, we will operate on the omega domain. Remember what I need to do, I will come back to this on this part. See, Sz omega e is given by RAO into S omega, well, S omega e. Okay. Now, so integration of that d omega e is integration of that d omega e. This is the area, this is the area under the response graph. What we should do is that this part we will write this way, we will call it RAO square. Now S omega e d omega e you will write as S omega d omega, because it is the same thing, integrate over the omega domain. You see what is happening, I had a problem, this becoming infinity, this becoming small. So I don't know how to find the area under that. So I had, when I did that, this also became infinity. But what I will do this. And if I did that, then I don't have a problem. Of course, you say this is omega e. What I will do, I will write this as R A O omega v mu. Because v is fixed, mu is fixed, so I will operate on the omega domain. So as far as area is concerned, in following wave, the problem gets automatically sorted out because I will operate on the omega domain if I want to, because the energy remains constant. If I were to run a computer program with omega e and if I did not have a control the way I broke it down, I may end up getting and hitting an omega e which is corresponding to this peak point, and then you will find out. For example, I did not choose, no, I chose some value here. It supposing my this discrete value, one of them chosen was this one. Let us say this is 0.4 and I use omega 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. At 0.4, I will find that omega is to be 0.2 and S omega is going to be infinity. If by luck I had instead at 0.4, I have 0.399, it will become 10 to the power of 9. Okay. So what I am saying is that to avoid this, it is better to always operate on the omega domain as far as area is concerned. And frankly, the shape of this graph, basically people do not realize it, because when I have a spectrum looking like this, infinity going like that and all that, infinity and all that, my response spectrum, you know, this is my so called my A, that S omega E, and my RAO is of course something like this. If I multiply this two, this will also look something like this, etc., you know, like that. And nobody really appreciates this kind of diagram, because this diagram does not reveal much. So in following waves, what I am saying is that in following waves, the shape of the spectrum may not be very important. In any case, the shape of the spectrum is only for illustration purpose. What is as important is of course finally finding out what is z⅓, what is z⅓, etcetera, etcetera, which are of course functions of m0, the area under the spectrum. And m0 here is this one, which is this one, and you are better off doing operation in this way. This, so this is one trick that we have to follow when we are doing this following wave condition. Actually, I did not mention, and then I will try to mention this part a little bit because we have a few minutes time. See, what is the physical significance of this? This omega e versus omega. What is the physical significance of this part? Spectrum going here to infinity. This, you know, what this corresponds to? This corresponds to the group speed of the waves, and energy travels at group speed. So what happened when the ship is traveling same as the group speed of the wave, then the energy of the wave cannot get away from the ship, and as a result the energy appears as infinity. Energy does not appear as infinity, energy gets trapped, so called. Just the same phenomena as sonic boom, same and resistance in a shallow water, etcetera. So what is happening here, the ship is moving, you see the waves are moving. Now what happened, zero frequency is of course when the speed of the ship and speed of the waves are same, but this one corresponds when speed of the ship is same as the group speed of the wave, which is half the phase speed. This is the speed at which the energy is traveling, the energy of the wave is traveling at that speed. Ship is also traveling at the same speed. Therefore, energy cannot get away from the ship, and as a result, it what is called a trapping phenomenon, it gets trapped. This is why this infinity comes in. This is the physical significance of this infinity, and this is, that is why in T part it is half. See here, this value is half of this value. This value is where the phase speed and the shift speed is same, zero frequency. This value is where it is half, that is where the energy goes, and this value is same as this value, this value is same as this value. That is what you will find out in the calculation part. Okay. So, this is one point that we need to realize when we are doing following wave. Now, let me also continue. How important, now following wave we have a problem. So, we have seen this calculation how we can do. Is it important for following wave? Should we worry about it? That is another question. See, from physical problem point of view, it turns out that when a ship moves, it has the usually the largest, usually that is one. Second thing, remember that this part violently goes up and down, and as it goes and hits below, which is what we call slamming, which we will discuss eventually. And if this comes down, the water goes up on the top, we call deck wetness or green shipping of green water is called. We know the ship, you will have seen, I have got excellent, I will show it to you sometime, excellent videos, clips, you know, of seeing how the nose of the ship has completely gone down the water and it comes up fully, you know, the water comes up entirely on top, and all these are vertical modes of motion, heave and pitch combined. All these are more important or significant in head waves. As a result, it is a, and falling waves it is less, not so much important, it is usually not so. This is why what is happening is that it is a head wave that or condition that has become more important, which is exactly why we did not pay enough attention in typical courses and all for how to get spectrum in following waves. Does it mean following waves are not important? The case where following wave is important, that is when this ship goes here and the waves follow, is actually in roll motion. It turns out that in following wave, roll motion can become very uncontrollable. It may end up getting kind of a very transient response and increase and capsizing. This phenomena is somewhat similar to a gripping phenomena. You see what happened when I go at the speed as the wave, then my restoration forces become very small. In some sense, it is something like you are trying to walk on a very slippery, you know, ground. So, when you go on a very slippery ground, then what happened? You have no grip. Actually, I learned this experience from, you know, like this driving on in Canada, for example, in this parking lot used to be full of ice, and we would try to drive and put a brake, and there is just no grip. You just feel there is no control. You see how this side goes in that side. Similar phenomena. So, normally, what I want to conclude saying is that following wave is important, but normally for day to day seakeeping evaluation, following wave is less important. And that is one of the reasons why in doing the spectral calculation, all the problems that we give normally, it has not been given such due importance. But having said that, you can always do this, and that is why all the problems that you end up getting, that there is an infinite S omega, etcetera, you know, we do not talk about it too much because we do not use it, following waves. But if you were to use it, and if it have to be done, then it is better to always use it in this formula, never mind the spectrum shape. Okay. So, with that I am going to end today, and we are going to go to next class. Now, we will go back to the next level of different spectrum. So, the 2D spectrum motions, I am finishing it here, we will go to the 3D spectrum tomorrow. Thank you. Thank you.